What's up, everybody? Welcome to Mother Trucking Monday. Today we're going to be going from Page, Arizona over to Las Vegas, Nevada. And that's what we're going to be hauling. Turned on the advanced coupling. I did try it out once, and it was definitely a bitch to line up the load to get it to attach. So we're going to try it here. I mean, you have to be dead on. They weren't kidding. And how they were saying you had to be dead on this thing, and just kind of hoping that I can get this in a timely manner. It's very hard to do when you can't see what the hell's going on. You know, to me, it almost looks like I'm lined up. I don't know if I have to go back further since it's a third-party trailer or what. I mean, to me, it looks like it's right there. So let's try this again. Tried this once without recording. Different truck. It was the same problem. You know, just trying to get perfectly in there. Trying to see if, you know, where you're at is, again, it's the hardest thing to do. And from the angle I'm at here, it looks like I am on it, and I'm not getting the message to take the trailer. Let's try from a different view, just a little bit anyway. There we go. So now that you're hooked, you still have to hit the take job button so it raises any feet and does whatever it needs to in the trailer. And no, these are not any kind of special trailers. I had these prior to the update. So anyway, the load is 55,000 pounds. It's not too heavy, but at least heavier than what we've been hauling. Whoop, wrong button. Wanted F5, there we go. Turn that off. And speaking of, how long of a trip is this? 11 hour trip, not too bad. And you know what I'm gonna do? Let's see here. I'm gonna try to straighten this thing up because I'm not gonna make that turn. Trailer. That was the curb, which is okay. I wanted to go up on it anyway. You know what? We'll go ahead and put beacons on, I guess. Pretty sure I have beacons on this thing. Yeah, there we go. Just up top there. Finally, a day trip. Got a little close to stopping there, but Anyway, finally a day trip. That is, that's a nice change. It's 2:34 in the afternoon, so chances are it's going to be dark by the time the video finishes up. But at least we get a little bit of time, some sunlight. Trip off. Try to start off in third just to see how she pulls. Not too bad. I mean, it was a bit sluggish there at the beginning. But I have no problem getting up to speed with it. Just to get this thing moving. So far, I'm liking the layout and the feel of Arizona. It has that desert canyon, really good feel. The colors are good, even though I do believe I'm running a color correction mod. To me, still, it looks very well off. I think we're on a 55 zone here. Actually 65. This transmission setup and engine setup I have is a great heavy hauler combination. I forgot the gear ratio that I put into the transmission. So far it's doing a really good job and makes me utilize all the gears. It's not so overpowering, you know, I can take this 55,000 pound load and start off in 5 low. So I like having to go through the gears. Now, take it, I don't have to start off in the very lowest gear. I could get away most likely starting off in second gear, but again, it's not fifth, so pretty happy with it. I do still have to upgrade the transmission type in the Freightliner Classic, though I'm not driving it right now, so I'm not going to really worry about it. The AI driver, I'm sure, can make do. But eventually, I would like to drive that truck again. Now, I think the goal is going to be to save up some money, and I don't know if I can expand the garage past 3 bays or not. If anything, I'll pick up another garage so I can pick up more trucks. Really get a good variety going into the fleet, get some more drivers hired, and then we can really start rolling in some money. Cruise set for a good, 68. 68 sounds good. So this whole trip, we're going to be staying inside the stock map again. There were a few jobs that took me all the way over to the East Coast, Washington, D.C. I think there was one in Maryland. There's one down in Georgia. I didn't want to take a super long trip this go-around. I want to see a little bit more of Arizona and, just kind of stay where all the scenery is. here. Oh boy, that speed limit drops pretty drastically. From a 65 to a 25 without warning, that could spell a disaster. Luckily this time I was actually paying attention to the speed limit signs coming up. A lot of times I do miss it. Miss the signs as I pass them. Oh boy, I didn't think I was going to stop there. Go on the trip. I think that said 8. Yep, 8 hours. Yeah, stopped pretty close to that one too. That view probably would not end well inside city limits with all the red lights and traffic going on. Gonna be hitting rush hour traffic here momentarily. I don't know if this road actually bends around to the left, or if it's a left-hand turn I have to make. I came up to points, okay, it's just a bend. I came to points before on the map where it doesn't show the roads that you can't enter. Now, usually it shows a little tiny sliver to let you know there is, but one or two times I have come up onto those areas and didn't indicate that, and, you know, wrong lane. Now with the advanced coupling, it doesn't have anything to do with the drop-off, of course. It's still the same thing, park it, hit the button to get done with your load. Oh boy. And just watch all the gear and everything go down and the job finishes up. So far, I am liking the advanced coupling. It adds a little bit more of a challenge to it, as you saw there in the beginning. Definitely not a master of it. We all know how my parking skills are. Not the best, that's for sure. But I am working on it. You know, in real life, I can park a trailer fairly decent, you know, attached to a pickup truck or an SUV. I don't have the problems that I do in this game. And I think it's mostly because, you know, I can't really turn around and look out the back window. I can't, just the objects in the side view mirror, it's so hard to, I guess, really tell how far away stuff is. Not trying to make excuses. I know I'm horrible at parking, but that's my issues with it anyway. My cruise control keep turning off.
Too much longer to go. 5 hours. Should be over fairly quickly. A damn Jake brake on this truck, man. Why it's sputtering like that. Through here. Five divorce, $100 down. Oh shit. I'm way up in a upper speed zone here. I think the next trip that I make, I'm really gonna try to get a super heavy load. At least the heaviest one I can find. 55,000 when I took this job was the heaviest. Prior to that, there was an 85,000 pound trailer, but I had to rest up, so I didn't have to do it, you know, 5 minutes into the video. Of course, that job expired. Hopefully I will find another one for the next video and really try to put this truck set up to the test, see how she hauls.
gear is holding it pretty well, actually. Still losing a little bit of momentum, but it's not falling off too quick. Like a neat area. Nice. Kind of wish I stopped and did some sightseeing there. But the cargo must be delivered. Gotta get the ratings and the money back up. Last I looked, I was around 20,000. Well, maybe I was wrong. A little over 16,000. So I got to get that money back up with the almost $8,000 a day loan payments going out. I have to rely on getting these jobs done in a timely manner. That's why right now I'm doing a bunch of quick ones just to get that money built back up. And hopefully my AI drivers will bring in some decent hauls and make me some damn money. It's kind of weird. I'm entering the... Oh, okay, there we go. Entering the city limit, it seemed like the speed limit went up. Making out fairly well with the red light cycles for once. Any other time seems like I'm always getting stuck in every single red light. That time the engine brake worked perfectly fine, so I don't know what is up with the sound file or maybe the way it was put together. Thank you. so hard just to maintain 30. My foot just wants to put it down on open roads like this. Alright, so look at that GPS. I guess this place is up here on the right. Sometimes it's so hard to tell how that GPS is showing it. On that smaller one, I kind of like the zoomed in version here on the F5 key. And I don't know exactly where I'm going to be parking either. I hate to go to the outside to, you know, get a better view. But the freedom of movement is only so far in this game, even with the head tracking. I know damn well that traffic's gonna pull up. It's gonna block my way to get in there. So maybe what I'll do is I'll just pull ahead here, let them by, and then I'll back myself in. Where did this traffic come from? Come on, keep it coming. Holy shit. My plan is backfiring. Kind of afraid to pull in there because I don't think I'd have enough room to either back it in or turn it around. I've stuck myself in those situations before and it takes me 20 minutes to park the truck. I swear, I think the AI hates me. Can I get it? Nope. I was hoping they'd stop a little further back. Scratched paint and I got stuck here. Definitely did not have enough to try to swing that thing in. right now, put myself too far that way. I said I'm getting the hang of it. Eventually. You guys are gonna look back one day on these videos, you're gonna be like, wow, you were such a shitty Parker. Now you are like a master. Probably not, but wishful thinking, right? I'm glad I didn't do this inside here, because I would have seriously screwed that stuff up. Oh gosh. Ready for unloading, but that is crooked as hell. I'm at least gonna try to straighten it up. I could have just gave up, but I do not want to. What would my videos be with a excellent park job? It would not be as entertaining. Oh, I might have to call it quits here in a minute. At least get it in there straighter. Oh, hold on. As long as the car goes straight, that's all that matters. Because I'm leaving. Look at that. Straight. Decoupling and done. Truck's not in that great of a position, but again, I'm leaving. The trailer's got to stay. Got an excellent rating. Just shy of level 11. That will definitely be reached on the next trip. Like, thank you guys for watching. Until next time. Alright guys, that's my time. And remember, if you did like the video, click the like button and share it with your friends. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing for more videos to come. And if you have time for another video, check out the one right here. As always, guys, thanks for watching, and until next time.